How's it guys, Monashia, and today we have a rank 1 6-star hood, soloing one of the most stacked bosses in Act 6, and making it look easy. So I just started playing with the buffed hood, and I didn't even know that the buffs were going live yesterday. In fact, I only updated today. I've kind of been out of it, a little bit more busy than usual this week, but yeah, so I started playing with the buffed hood, and I must say, I've just been enjoying this champ so much that I'm not even too bothered about them removing the, the Fate Seal mechanic, because he still has the stagger, which is a very powerful form of buff control, and his is pretty reliable now. In fact, it might be the most reliable in the game now, because it's just so easy to apply, all you have to do is crit. Okay, so now we're facing the Hydra Adaptoid, and this is a very good matchup for Hood. There's just so much working for him in this fight. He gets buffs pretty regularly, there's the one-hit special attack, the not having a special 3 so he can play very aggressively, the Matador node making it very quick for you to get to that special 2. So yeah, Hood is just really good for this matchup now. He actually makes it pretty easy. One might even say cheesy, because this is just a rank 1 6-star Hood. I think he's Sig 20, could be 40, but I think it's 20. No boosts, no suicides, no synergies, and I finished this fight in under 4 minutes and lost about 4% health. Although I know his regen is currently bugged right now, but even so, it wouldn't have made a difference in terms of the outcome of the fight. Also, this is only my third fight, or my third time using the buffed Hood, so I might not be the best at playing him yet. Although, he's not that difficult to play, it's more about optimizing your damage and managing those charges. But for this fight, I wasn't really trying to get it done quickly or anything like that, I was just sort of getting a feel for the new Hood, and I must say that I'm just genuinely enjoying this champ so much that I'll probably rank 2 him very soon. And one of the main reasons for that is just the new miss mechanic he has, like the invisibility is just so much more reliable now, giving you 2 guaranteed misses. Which might not seem like much, but you can get around a lot with those 2 misses, especially if you can go invisible frequently enough. Like in this fight I can. Also the stagger being guaranteed whenever you crit is quite nice now. Then there's the new ability, the Hex Pistol. I wonder if that's a play on words, like they got it from the Sex Pistols. So yeah, there's this new Hex Pistol ability, which is pretty cool in terms of damage. So right now it's just that skull looking icon that you can see on the Adaptoid, which gets applied whenever you throw a medium attack or a special 2. So right now I've applied over 50 of them, but they're not really doing anything, they are kind of just there, but when they expire they deal a burst of passive energy damage. But the thing is, whenever you apply one it refreshes the rest of them, so it's actually quite difficult to let them expire even if you're not playing that aggressively. But that's where the heavy attack comes in, because it will cause all those hexes to expire with 75% increased potency. So you can do a massive amount of burst damage by stacking up a lot of them before throwing that heavy attack. And by massive, I mean like 6-figure numbers with the rank 1 6-star. I think it caps at 100 though, I haven't actually tried, I just saw it somewhere, so yeah, I might be wrong about that, just need to double check. So I'm actually about to use it now. I threw 2 heavies in this fight and I had 84 hexes for the first one, which did about 220,000 damage. And the fact that it's just one burst of passive energy damage means that it's going to be pretty good for just getting through a lot of nodes or abilities that trigger towards the end of the fight. And it's just fun watching the opponent's health literally disappear like that, because it's just a single burst of damage, so the health bar moves from one point to another. So at this point of the fight I was really starting to have fun, just playing with the invisibility a bit more. Like I'm literally walking through special attacks, going in and out of combos, even chaining combos, like ending a combo with a medium attack, then immediately start a new combo without parrying or dexing, cause you know he will miss. And I just love playing like this, it's so fun and carefree. You can pretty much do whatever you want until those 2 misses. It's almost like being invincible or indestructible, except the opponent doesn't actually hit you, so you don't even get fazed by it. You just carry on smacking him like nothing happened. And just being invisible allows you to get some very easy openings. In fact, if you counter fast enough, it counts as an intercept. And I don't think I need to tell you how valuable that is, just the amount of nodes or abilities in this game that sort of require you to intercept. Having a champ that can do it very easily or reliably is pretty valuable. You know, it's one of the things that makes Ghost such a great champ. Like check this, I'm gonna throw one more special 2 and then rush in while he throws a special 1. Then I can just throw a heavy attack even though he's unstoppable, because you'll just miss and then he dies. So all those special 2s do sort of inflate the hit count, but still the fight took less than 5 minutes with a rank 1 6-star with no boosts or suicides or synergies. and finished with close to full health. So yeah, Hood is just really great for this fight, and I'm really enjoying this champ, I must say. So he'll probably be rank 2 in the next video I make with him. But yeah, that's gonna be it for this one. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you for watching, have a wonderful day, and I'll see you soon.